Hello, fellow Earth scientists! Bee here. Today, we're going to be exploring the systems that make up our planet, the Earth's spheres. Every habitat, biome, and landscape on Earth is a delicate balance between many different pieces, like the water and sea life in a coral reef, or the jagged rocks and cold weather atop a mountain. Changing just one of these pieces can have a huge impact on everything involved in that balancing act. For example, imagine a beach, cool waves splashing on the powdery sand, seagulls flying on warm breezes, and schools of fish darting through the seaweed. Now, imagine changing any of the pieces of this delicate system. What would happen? Well, imagine that the plants and animals in the ocean suddenly disappeared. Without the gases they produce, the very air we breathe would be different. If the air was different, those warm, beachy breezes might be replaced with blizzards or scorching droughts. If the weather was different, the ocean itself would change, and maybe even evaporate away. And without the ocean's waves to crush up corals, rocks, and shells, there'd be no sand. Would any of that even still qualify as a beach? As you can tell, all of the parts in this system are closely related. Changing one will result in changes to all of the others that can span the entire world. These different components are part of systems called the Earth's spheres that work together to make up every single thing on our planet. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain what the Earth's four spheres are, explain why the Earth's spheres are each important parts of the Earth system, and explain how the Earth's spheres interact. Let's get started! From the deepest movements in the planet's core to the formation of weather miles above the ground, the Earth is home to millions of connected processes. Together, we call them the Earth system. The Earth system is all of the natural processes that happen and interact on Earth. But think back to the beach example. Although the sand, water, winds, and sea life were all connected, do you think they're influenced by the same processes? The different parts of a beach are representative of different parts within the Earth system, and each is shaped by its own unique set of processes. The Earth system is made of four smaller systems called spheres that are each distinct but connected: the atmosphere, the hydrosphere, the geosphere, and the biosphere. These four systems work together to form the entirety of the Earth system. The first sphere we'll take a closer look at is the atmosphere. The first part of the word atmosphere is the prefix atmo, which means vapor or gas. So, with this in mind, pause the video here and take a moment to jot down your predictions about what might be part of this system. The atmosphere is the system that contains all of Earth's air. The air in Earth's atmosphere is made of a mix of different gases, including nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and water vapor. So, you can probably already tell how the atmosphere is closely linked to all life on Earth, since we need air to live. Supporting life isn't the only job of the atmosphere, though. This layer of gases also keeps the conditions on our planet stable by regulating the temperature and deflecting radiation from space. The atmosphere is also where Earth's weather patterns form. From a gentle breeze to a raging hurricane, the atmosphere is home to it all. The hydrosphere's name contains the prefix hydro, which means water. So, the hydrosphere contains, you guessed it, all the water on Earth. This includes the salt water in the oceans and seas, as well as fresh water in rivers and lakes, and frozen in glaciers. It even includes the water stored in deep underground reservoirs, and the water vapor in clouds. The hydrosphere is truly a huge system. About 3/4 of our planet's surface is covered in water, and that doesn't even include the water above and below the ground. The presence of a hydrosphere is part of what makes Earth unique, and what makes it able to support life. The hydrosphere has impacts on every other sphere within the Earth system too. For example, as water moves around the planet in ocean currents, it can affect weather patterns like global temperatures and rainfall. Next up is the geosphere. The prefix geo means Earth. So, what do you think the geosphere is? It includes all the rocks and minerals on Earth's surface and below. That means all of the land on every continent and island is part of the geosphere. So is the sea floor, and the even deeper layers of molten metal below the Earth's crust. Like the other spheres, the geosphere is constantly changing as it's shaped by a variety of different processes. Huge segments of the Earth's crust are constantly shifting, rearranging the continents themselves inch by inch. Volcanoes are erupting and slowly creating new mountain ranges. And deep within the Earth's mantle and outer core, molten rock is flowing, influencing this volcanic activity. But, as we know by now, the geosphere is part of a larger system, so it's also impacted by the other spheres. Strong winds in the atmosphere wear mountains down into dust over millions of years. Similarly, the constant crashing of waves in the hydrosphere breaks rocks from the sea floor apart into sand. Processes in all of Earth's other spheres have shaped the geosphere into the world we call home today. So, we've talked about the atmosphere, hydrosphere, and geosphere. Air, water, and rocks cover just about everything on Earth's surface, right? Wait. What about us? Humans are part of the fourth and final sphere, the biosphere. The prefix bio means life, so the biosphere includes all living things. That means everything from birds flying miles above the ground, to bizarre fish at the bottom of the sea, to humans walking through cities together. We're all part of the biosphere. So are towering trees, forests of seaweed, bioluminescent mushrooms, and blooming flowers. In fact, so are the tiny, single-celled bacteria and other microorganisms that live in the soil beneath these plants' roots. If it's on Earth, and it's alive, it's part of the biosphere. Of course, the biosphere interacts with every other sphere in many unique ways. Think about a forest full of trees. They bury their roots deep within soil containing dirt from the geosphere. They take in water from the hydrosphere when it rains. Then, they absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release oxygen into it. Trees are just one example of how the biosphere is connected to all of the other spheres in the Earth system. Can you think of another way the biosphere interacts with a different sphere, like the atmosphere or hydrosphere? Pause the video here and write down your thoughts in your guided notes. Every living thing in the biosphere needs the air from the atmosphere, the water from the hydrosphere, and the rocks from the geosphere to survive. And at the same time, those other spheres rely on each other too. All of these spheres are closely interconnected. Together, they form the Earth system. A system that we don't just need, but that we're also an essential part of. So, let's recap what we've learned today. You now know that the Earth system is the system of all the natural processes happening on Earth. The Earth system contains the atmosphere, hydrosphere, geosphere, and biosphere. Each of Earth's spheres play an essential role in shaping our planet. And all of the different spheres are closely interconnected. Be sure to check out the engaging practice games and thought-provoking PDF extension activities that go with this lesson. They'll help you get ready for our next lesson, where we'll explore some of the cycles that happen within these spheres. And remember, in Earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time! Hey, hey.